In this video, we're going to be introducing the topic of slope. To do this, let's learn about the slope of a line. Throughout the video, there will be instances where you are asked to pause the video and answer a question that has been posed. Doing so, by either writing your answers down on the corresponding worksheets or organizing the thoughts in your head, will allow you to move through the video more easily, as well as solidify your understanding of the content being discussed in the video. For an activator, you were asked to go onto My MCPS Classroom discussion board and write some numbers that are equivalent to 15 divided by 12 and share some of the strategies you use to arrive at your answers. If you have not done the activator yet, pause the video, go to the discussion board, and pose a response before reviewing the answers in this video. Now that you've posted on the discussion board, let's take a look at some of the answers that would have been equivalent to 15 divided by 12. We could write 15 divided by 12 as a fraction just with the given numbers. We could then reduce that fraction to 5 over 4. We could turn our reduced fraction into a mixed fraction of 1 and 1 fourth. We could keep the original denominator of 12 and write a mixed fraction of 1 and 3 twelfths. Or we could use long division and get an answer with a decimal 1.25. There are, of course, other equivalent answers to 15 divided by 12. These are only some of the many possible answers to this question. We want to keep in mind the idea of equivalent ratios, or multiple ways to represent the same number, as we work through the problems in this video. For our first problem, the figure shows three right triangles, each with its longest side on the same line. So in my figure, I'm going to label the right angles, and I notice that the longest side is attached to this line that's running diagonal through the grid. Using the figure, can you determine whether any of the triangles are similar to one another? If we take a look at the figure, we notice that we have triangle ABC, triangle CDE, and triangle FGH. We can also notice that some of the sides for some of the triangles are labeled for us with their lengths. We're going to go ahead and use the given information and fill out this table below. For triangle ABC, we notice that the horizontal side has a length of 4 and the vertical side has a length of 3. We're going to fill that in our chart. For our large triangles, triangle CDE, we notice that the vertical side has a length of 6. And for our small triangle, FGH, we notice that the horizontal side has a length of 2. We're going to use triangle ABC as a comparison for the other two triangles because it has information on both of the sides filled out. For triangles to be similar, we need to think back to a vocabulary word that we addressed in the first quarter of the year, and that is the two triangles must be proportional. Proportional means having a constant ratio to another quantity. So we want to be able to see if we have a ratio that is consistent with triangle ABC and the other triangles within the figure. If I look at my table that I've filled out, I see that triangle ABC has a vertical side length of 3, and triangle CDE has a vertical side length of 6. I know that 6 is twice the length of 3. If these triangles were similar triangles, this relationship would remain true for the horizontal sides as well. So if I know the horizontal side of ABC is 4, I would simply have to double it, and CDE would have a horizontal side length of 8. If I look at the diagram and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The horizontal side length does have a length of 8. So triangle ABC and triangle CDE are similar triangles. Now that we know triangle ABC and triangle CDE are similar, take a second, pause the video, and see if you can determine if ABC and FGH are also similar triangles. Now that you've had a minute to think it over, let's discuss. If we look at triangle ABC, we notice that there is a horizontal side length of 4, and for triangle FGH, there is a horizontal side length of 2. The ratio between 4 and 2 would be to divide by 2. So for these triangles to be similar to one another, that ratio would need to remain constant for the vertical side as well. If I take 3, the side length of ABC, and divide it by 2, I should get 1.5 or 1.5. If I look at the triangle on the grid, I go 1.5 length. So my vertical side length is 1.5. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle FGH, which means all three of the triangles are similar to one another. Now that I know the triangles are similar, what does this mean about the line that all the triangles are connected to? Well, whenever we have a line, we can construct triangles like these where one side is the horizontal and one side is vertical. And the quotient of the length of the vertical and horizontal side will always be the same. This number is called the slope of the line. The slope is the vertical length divided by the horizontal length. So if we take a look at the figure above, we have the blue triangle with the horizontal length and the vertical length labeled, similar to the triangles we saw in the previous diagram. If we take a look at the blue triangle, I have a horizontal length of 8 and a vertical length of 6. You can double check these by counting. Therefore, if I'm following the rules for slope, it is the vertical length divided by the horizontal length. Therefore, using the blue triangle, I would say the slope of this line is 6/8. However, if we look at the orange triangle, it's a different size. If I was to count the length of the horizontal and vertical sides of the triangle, I would see that the horizontal length is 4 and the vertical length is 3. So I would say the slope of the line is 3/4. While these two numbers are different, we think back to the activator where we looked for equivalent ways to represent the same number. 6/8 and 3/4 are equivalent ratios. This means that even though the triangles that we use are different sizes, we'll still get the same ratio to represent the slope. Another way we can think about these triangles is for horizontal length, we can say it is the run, and the vertical length is the rise. Therefore, we could say that slope is equivalent to the rise over the run, or the vertical length divided by the horizontal length. I'm going to use this idea of rise over run to help me with my next practice problem. Draw two lines with a slope of 3. What do you notice about the two lines? If I'm going to draw my first line, I know that 3, my slope of 3, I can write as 3/1. Therefore, I will need a triangle that rises 3 and runs 1. I'm going to start at this point here, and I'm going to go up 1, 2, 3, Here's my rise of three, or my vertical length. And I'm going to run one. There is my horizontal length. And I'm then going to connect the points to make my line. Another equivalent ratio that I could use to represent 3 is 6 over 2. So I'm going to draw another line with a different size triangle to see if the lines will remain similar. I'm going to start here, and I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, rise of 6, or my vertical length, and a run of 2. I will then connect the lines together. What do you notice about the two lines? For one thing, this reinforces the fact that even though our triangles are different rise and run, we still get lines of the same slope. We can also notice that these two lines have the same slope, therefore, they are parallel to each other and they will not intersect. The second part of the question asks you to draw two lines with a slope of 1/2. Then, what do you notice about the two lines? I want you to take a second, pause the video, and try to draw two lines with a slope of 1/2. Keep in mind that you can use different similar triangles to draw the two lines. Now that you've had a chance to draw two lines with a slope of 1/2, let's discuss. For my two lines, I drew a line with a triangle that had a rise of 1 and a run of 2, which would be consistent with the slope of 1/2. I drew another line with a rise of 2 and a run of 4, which would also be consistent with the slope of 1/2. Therefore, both of these lines meet the requirement of having a slope of 1/2. We can now also notice that the lines with a slope of 3 are much steeper than the lines with a slope of 1/2. This indicates that the larger the slope is, the more vertical our line will be, and that the less the slope is, the more horizontal our line will be. Let's take a minute and reflect on what we've just discussed. What is the slope triangle for a line? How can you use a slope triangle to find the slope of a line? Does it matter which two points you use to create a slope triangle? Why or why not? Take a minute, pause the video, and reflect on the questions below. When you're finished, unpause and we can discuss some of the answers. The slope triangle for a line is a right triangle whose longest side is on the line and the other sides are horizontal and vertical. We also can use the terms rise and run for horizontal and vertical. How can you use a slope triangle to find the slope of a line? We would divide the length of the vertical side, the rise, by the length of the horizontal side, the run. Again, you can use rise over run when thinking about slope. Does it matter which two points you use to create a slope triangle? Why or why not? As long as both points are on the line, it will not matter. All of the triangles that can be formed will be similar and have equivalent ratios. This means that regardless of the two points, the slope will be the same. In this lesson, I can draw a line on a grid with a given slope. I can also find the slope of the line on a grid.